Its rich in water resources, whose development has been the basis for the social economy development.
It is indeed one of the lowest prices in the world. I mean, I'm coming from Netherlands, and in Netherlands we are paying also very, very little for water. It's not unique to Malaysia. A family of four in Netherlands, like mine, would be paying on a yearly basis only about 250 euros. The price of a cubic meter in Europe is about 1.5 cubic meter. So it's very low price. Why is that? It's historically based, because the water has been seen, and maybe rightly so, as a human right. You and I and every farmer in India and all the way up to Africa has to have access to water, like air. You have to breathe, you have to drink. That notion is conditioned by our existence. Now, of course, that notion is coming from the historical human right perspective, and it is not anymore a notion which can stand for the future, because water is becoming the enabling economic driver of all the economies, so we need to put price tag on it. And again, it is a matter of the partnership between the government and the pricing to be enabling the system where the poorest still will have water, but those who can afford to pay for water will pay. So I am very much for the differentiated price in water. It can be done either through the direct pricing or taxing. In Netherlands, we do it through taxing. So part of my tax, which I am paying back, goes to the water sector. It goes to both drinking water supply, but also to the flood defense. So we will need to increase the water price, but not flat rate to everyone. It should be a combined water pricing, where part of the price will come from the tax system, and it will be based on the income level of those who are paying the taxes, so it's a differentiated pricing. The most important is to realize, again, that water is not issue for one political party, it's not issue for one province, it's not issue for federal government only, it's an issue for a true governance partnership, because it's cutting through all disciplines. How can you solve a water policy issue at the level of the province when the river is flowing through three or five provinces? You need to collaborate. You need to collaborate in the cross-provincial boundaries. It's also important to realize that the best approach to water issue is at the beginning of the chain. We discussed during this morning's symposium, for example, the water pollution standards in Malaysia. And I think it's very important that the water pollution standard will be taken up from the beginning of the chain, which is producing of polluted water, all the way up to the treatment and reuse. Again, this needs partnership, because who else can establish the standards for the releasing of polluted water than government? Who else can comply with the standards and invest than the private sector? Who else can produce a innovative technologies for water treatment of those waters which are left after these two steps? It's the R&D and scientists. And who else can comply with all of this is the citizens, because they need to be informed about the fact that polluting surface water is polluting the water you may drink next day or next morning. So it's, again, partnership between the governmental institutional policies, the private sector, the R&D technology innovating to treat water, and all of us to realize where is water coming from and how can we contribute to this cycle of the system, water system, to solve the issue we talk about.